everybody. Yay. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the premiere podcast of the David Perry Show. Hey, everybody. Thank you for joining in. Yes. And in case those of you who do not know, I'm David Perry, and I'm the owner of Diana Darby Model Management. So my company is located here in the DMV area. I've been in the modeling industry for over 10 years. I have started my company 5 years ago, and now I'm branching into model development classes. I coach runway and posing classes. I also help models with model development, meaning I help them with their portfolio, update that, and I also help them find clients. So I do it all, as well as look good, but I also, forget that part, guys. I wanted to say thank you for coming and joining in on my very first podcast. Can y'all all tell that I'm very nervous? But believe me, it'll wear off real soon. But I'm also so very excited. And I want to, again, thank you all for joining in. We're going to have a great show. We're our special guest tonight. We're going to have Cleopatra Couture, who is also going to be coming on talking about her new project. So she has a lot to talk about. We will have model and actress Gina Gordon. She's going to come and talk about a lot of the work she's done. And she also has some great new projects coming in. And we're going to have Veronica. Veronica, you're going to have to tell me how to pronounce your last name. Iyanga, Veronica Iyanga, and she is the executive director of My Girlfriend's House Incorporated. So she's going to be talking a lot about the upcoming projects that she has in store. One of them I will be involved with. So we're going to be talking about all of that, as well as a lot of great fashion talk, things that are happening in the industry. Just going to be having a fun time for my premiere show. We're not going to get too heavy-handed. We're not going to get too serious. This is going to be an introduction. It's going to be lighthearted. We're going to have some fun. And as I said before, we're going to talk a lot about what's happening with my guest. I see we got some viewers coming in on our Facebook Live page. Hi, guys. Great to see you. Thank you for joining in. We got some viewers in the house, too. I see Rodney Branch from Copa Style Magazine. He's up in here. Of course, my guests are here. We also have my two models from our Junior Bosses of Fashion Workshop Competition. It's a foundation. It's part of Cleopatra Couture's. She's going to be discussing that along with some of the other great projects that she has. And so we got a lot to work with today, and you guys, please stay along with us, have some fun, and see what's going to be happening. Any questions? Anybody got any questions? I guess I got a lot more to say, don't I? Excuse me? Yes, why don't we take a break, and then we are going to bring in my first guest, and by the time we come back, all these little nooks and crannies and kinks that you just saw a few seconds ago will be worked out. We're going to be fabulous. Talk to you later. See you soon.
Follow in the crowd. It's
Welcome back to the David Perry Show. And if anybody has seen the movie Hairspray, the original version with Divine, you would know exactly what I meant when I said it that way. The David Perry Show. Anyway, I have my first guest here tonight. Iffy, all this time I've known you, please pronounce your last name for me.
Onya, O-N-Y-I-A. Onya, you just say all the syllables.
Iffy Onya. And she is the head designer, creator of Cleopatra Couture. She is also going to be speaking about her latest upcoming projects, the Junior Bosses of Fashion Foundation. And guess what? This fabulous lady right here is going to be starting a new fashion week in our DMV area. I'm definitely going to have her talk about that. So Iffy, welcome. I'm so
thank
glad
you,
to have you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So let's get started, because we got a lot to talk to with you about.
Yes, you do.
Let's go ahead and get started on talking about the Junior Bosses of Foundation Workshop Competition. Tell us about it. How did you get it started, and what is it about?
Okay, so I relocated from London to here, and when I first got here, I didn't know a lot of people here, so I went from fashion to healthcare, and then a few years later, I went back into fashion. And being in the fashion industry in the U.S. is different to being in the fashion industry in Europe. Mm-hmm. And you have to have the technical know-how, you have to have the connections and stuff. And that's how come I came up with this idea.
Speaking to your mic, Iffy, they're not catching you out there in the world.
I'm so sorry, people. I'm sorry.
I need to hear you and see you, love.
Oh, my sexy voice.
Exactly.
Okay, so I've run successful businesses. I've been a business consultant for so many years. And having to go back into fashion and learning all the ideas and the different aspects of it, I decided that I wanted to give back to the community. And I also believe that a lot of our young ones don't know how to set up a good, successful business, which is why you can start a business and 3 years down the line, it crashes.
Exactly.
And how do you do it? And not trying to differentiate, but a lot in the African-American community, mm-hmm. we don't have generational wealth. Because, you know, the idea of monkey see, monkey do, mm-hmm. You have to know what you're teaching somebody. And a lot of our parents didn't know what to teach us, teach our kids.
Right.
So I took it upon myself to open up the Junior Bosses of Fashion Workshop competition that's open to everybody from ages 8 to 16
that sounds great.
Mm-hmm. And basically what we're doing, the first module is business management and administration.
Mm-hmm.
We're teaching you what's the difference between an incorporation, LLC, sole proprietorship.
Something I'm learning myself.
Right. Okay. How do you
for
get to EIN number, which stands for employee identification number.
I got that.
Because, you know, you got to pay the tax man. And then how do you write a business plan? How do you write a proposal to get funding?
Mm-hmm.
Things like that I think you need to know. Mm-hmm. How do you come up with a business logo, a slogan?
It's amazing because what you just spoke about is pertinent to what a lot of young people need to know
mm-hmm.
to be involved in business or just need to know to navigate life.
Right.
Because it's funny how we teach them certain skills.
Mm-hmm.
Teach them how to spend money,
mm-hmm.
All of that. But a lot of us aren't teaching our young adults and our upcoming generation how to invest, how to be wise about their money, how to save, how to prepare.
Right.
And I think that's a good idea, especially in the fashion industry.
Exactly. Because, you know, the fashion industry is like,
it's crazy.
So, it's crazy.
Okay, for lack of a better word, it's crazy.
Yeah, it's so flashy, and you can get carried away with the popping of the champagne and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And you're making your little money, and then you're spending it back out again. But how
exactly.
do you reinvest it into yourself?
That's the point. You're spending, and then you're not showing anything for it.
Mm-hmm.
Or you're spending, and you're not investing, or you're not spending wisely, if that
right.
makes sense.
Right.
I want to jump real quick before we go to DMV Fashion Week.
Mm-hmm.
I want to bring out two of our outstanding students from the JBF Foundation. I want to bring out Paige Taysen and Chandler Steele. Chandler, by the way, was featured in Copa Style magazine by editor-in-chief Rodney Branch. But I want to bring them out. Come on out, guys. I don't know if the camera is going
to
catch you, but why don't you come on over here?
Come on.
Why don't you step on over? Yeah, give them a hand. And these two young, gorgeous students are in our... Yes, say hi to the world, Paige and Chandler. They are part of the... Thank cute. Thank you, Igor. Y'all got microphones. They're part of the Junior Bosses of Fashion workshop competition, mm-hmm. JBF, for you out there. And I just wanted to bring them on stage, give you a look at what we have to offer. I have worked with Chandler. He was in my first fashion show, mm-hmm. and he has also performed in New York Fashion Week. And Paige is a newcomer. She was brought to me by Mrs. DC America, Leah Rochelot.
Yes.
Guys, you want to have a few words to say real quick? What do you think about the JBF?
I love it already. We've only had, two lessons, and I've already learned so much. There's so much information, and there's only 6 classes, and there should be more because there's so much information, and it's a lot of fun. The time just flies by. It's really fun.
Thank you. I love
Thank
it.
Thank you. Hey.
Yeah, and I like that idea. Maybe if you might want to think about, having it more longer.
We're gonna do a, mm-hmm. a master class.
It's like a fashion school. That's and yes. The woman that did my makeup, Karen Hobson of the Blessed Touch Makeup Artistry, Karen Bonita. Uh-huh. She is like the head of the makeup department. So right. She's gonna be teaching students about makeup artistry. I have been brought on by IFE to help run the modeling department. So I'm gonna be Dr. David Perry running the modeling portion of the school. Chandler, tell me, what do you like about the JBF?
Honestly, I've learned a lot about modeling in general and like how to pose and just walking in general. Like, you've taught me a lot about,
thank you.
And I'm really thankful that you have just given me this opportunity to like just teach me. Like, and I really enjoy it a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, Chan. I like that. See, I pay them wisely to say that, by the way. But I love it. Thank you, guys. Y'all are the best. And there's going to be more schooling, more teaching, more coaching to come. So be prepared to work hard, all right? All right, Paige and Chandler. Guys, give them a hand. Thank you so much for coming out. Aren't they absolutely gorgeous? Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
And Iffy, I think we have a few more minutes. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about the DMV Fashion Week.
Yes.
I really want you to get into this because this is something I am so looking forward to. So how did that come about?
Okay, so I started off by doing a Midsummer Madness fashion show.
I know your fashion show.
You know
show.
That. Mm-hmm. So which used to air every June.
Yep.
And that's just really to show my British heritage. But as it grew bigger and wider, I realized there was something lacking in the DMV area. There wasn't a platform that was open to bring all the designers and the different shows that everybody has mm-hmm. together.
Right.
So mm-hmm. if you came into DC and you wanted to know what was happening in the fashion industry, you can go onto our website and mm-hmm. go to the calendar, and it will point you to all the shows. The shows all don't have to answer DMV Fashion Week.
Right.
We are following the same pattern and standards that has been set forth by New York Fashion Week, London Fashion Week, Paris Fashion Week.
Good, I like that.
And
we should.
Yes, we mm-hmm. should.
I mean, there's no reason why not. I mean, DC is like the seat of international government.
Yeah.
We should be having like a fabulous array of designers mm-hmm. showing here.
And you know, we're neglected, but we're the capital.
Yeah,
we have a lot of fashionistas mm-hmm. over here. We have a lot of talented people like
yes.
Karen Hobson,
exactly,
who is our creative director for the DMV Fashion
there
Week.
You go.
And also she cheers the makeup team. So she's the head of the glam
squad. So she'll be bringing in hair and makeup. She's going to be turning it, right?
Yeah.
There you go.
Right.
Oh, cool.
So, and of course yourself.
Yes, me.
And Rebel Royal.
I'm a runway diva, a coach extraordinaire. I'm going to turn them out.
Okay, that's funny. But so that's what the DMV Fashion Week is about. We're bringing buyers. We're bringing industry people. We're bringing boutiques. We're bringing fashion houses to attend, and also the media. Mm-hmm. I had a conversation with Washington Post today.
Ooh,
so we are bringing all those people to the show mm-hmm. to showcase the best and the best of DMV area. And also some international designers are coming, and some people are coming from outside the DMV area, from Atlanta, from Texas and stuff. But it's open to everybody, but we really just want to showcase that we're here. We're the fashion people.
We are, and we're going to show everybody how fashion people we are. As a matter of fact, Igor, do we have a copy of the DMV promo video reel? I'd like to show that.
Yeah.
Great. Could you show that for us, please? Thank you, sir.
The DMV Fashion Week is happening August the 9th through the 11th. we'll be showcasing the top designers, models, and artists from the DMV. Models, designers, press, vendors, and sponsors can now register online.
That was great. So that was a promo for your upcoming DMV Fashion Week.
Yes.
August 9th through the...
August 11th.
August.
And we have...
August 9th through the 11th.
Yes. And we have a model casting coming up.
Yes. Our model casting is coming up June 2nd, is that correct?
9th.
June 9th.
You should know this. You're running this stuff.
I should know this. And you know what? You're absolutely right. I do know it. And our casting call is coming up. It's going to be Sunday, right? June 9th. I think 2 to 5.
2 to 5.
At the Cleopatra Couture Studios. We do not have a flyer for that. I apologize. But I'm sure if you go to the website, right? Mm-hmm. All the information will be there. And the website is www.dmv-fw.com. Is that correct? All right. You still got a few more minutes. Is there anything else you would like to say? You got a couple minutes to hang out with me for a few more minutes. Is there something you would like to touch base on before you have to go?
Oh, you know you can never ask a Nigerian if they have anything else to say. Of course I have a lot to say.
Okay, all right then. How about that fierce blouse you're going to be making for me? All right, that's enough of that, guys. But I will just, as I said, we'll just touch base on you are running the DMV.
The Junior Bosses of Fashion Workshop competition has 6 modules.
Yep.
The business administration, and then the kids will select fashion designing or fashion makeup artistry or styling or modeling or fashion photography. And we have industry people that none of them have less than 15 years experience in that field that are teaching each module.
Good.
And the winners of this competition will be featured at the DMV Fashion Week on the Saturday, the 10th. Mm-hmm. That's going to be the junior and urban fashion showcase. Mm-hmm. And then the Sunday is the Atelier fashion showcase.
I love it.
And then they're also going to participate in the New York Fashion Week next year, as well as be featured in 3 magazines, the Copa Style magazine, which is the DMV famous magazine.
Gentleman Page, why don't y'all come back on over here and get one more for the road before y'all have to head off too.
Right, and then Just Right magazine, which is a magazine that is specifically for the plus size models. And then...
Let's bring them back, what we're talking about. Yeah.
And then Tricia J International Magazine will be covering both the workshop competition as well as the DMV Fashion Week.
Thank you so much, Ife, on Yaya. No, I'm sorry. Okay, you can spike me later. Please do.
I break bread with this man.
Isn't that terrible? But Ife,
Onya,
thank you so much for everything and for being my first guest, one of my first guests on my premiere podcast. How about that? You know, I think you're bringing me some good luck. You were at my first fashion show.
Mm-hmm.
When we first met at the studio, we became fast friends after that.
Instantly.
So I think you are a good luck charm for me. I think I'm going to keep you around for a while, if you don't mind.
No, not at all. Not at all.
But right now, I have to bring in my next guest. So we're going to say goodbye and farewell and au revoir and see you back soon. In fact, I'd like for you to come back and talk more in details, especially when it gets closer to the DMV Fashion Week.
You got it.
All right, everybody.
My pleasure.
Ify, Chandler, and Paige ahead. Thank you, everybody.
Bye-bye.
And we get ready to go on another break. And when we return, I will have my next guest, model and actress Gina Corden, and she's going to come in and talk about all things Hollywood.
Yay!
Everywhere you go!
everybody. We're back. Yay. Oh, we lost our audience. Okay. Yay.
Hi, guys.
We're back, everybody, to all of you out there who care.
Hey, what's up?
We're back with our with my second guest at the premiere podcast of The David Perry Show. Y'all supposed to say it like that now. The David Perry Show. All right. They're working it out. Yes. Oh, I think I need to come to the late night crowd. But that being said, we have our next guest.
You're going live.
We have our next guest, Gina Corden. Gina is a movie and television actress, model. Yes. I've known Gina when I started my modeling career. That's how long we've known each other. Trying to get us back both on Facebook Live. Y'all can see us, right? Okay. But yes, but she's going on to much more successful things, and I'm going to have her talk about a little bit of that, starting with my favorite part. You know what I want to ask you about.
Go for it.
She was in The Walking Dead. She was also in the movie Office Christmas Party. But why don't we start with The Walking Dead? How did you get that?
Yeah. Well, I'm starting off acting. I'm very, sorry. So I'm starting off with an acting career. And I'm very new to it. I'm starting off with a background work. I worked as a background extra on The Walking Dead for season 7. I also was a walker later on during the season. I had so much fun on that set, and I made so many great friends, and just watching the principal actors work together was incredible. Everybody was just so humble and down to earth. Of course, as background actors, you can't actually meet the principal cast. You have to, you know, have set etiquette and be professional, but just there's something magical about that set. And it's so funny because they have different communities on The Walking Dead, like Alexandria, Oceanside.
Oh, wow.
And I was on the Oceanside team, but I'm from Alexandria. And I remember telling somebody, one of the crew working, that I'm originally from Alexandria, Virginia. They're like, oh my gosh, that's so cool. Are you really from Alexandria? I was like, yeah. And I just got to say, like, it feels so good to be home right now. And
in
the DC area, just like even walking outside, I was like, I'm home. Yay.
So you obviously have to travel a lot for your career.
Yeah.
Is that what you mean? I wanted to ask you, said walking. Is that a term? Is that a lingo, a business lingo term for extra? Or
a walking?
Were you more than
a walker is like a zombie, basically.
Oh, so it's the term for what the show is about.
Yeah.
Y'all knew that, you Walking Dead fans out there. You knew what she was talking about.
But,
I just told on myself. I didn't. I'm sorry. But I'm glad you explained that. I understand now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I recommend anybody that's trying to get into the acting business, you know, start out with the background extra work and, you know, learn how things go and watch the principal actors work. And you gain so much experience that way, and see if it's really for you. But again, like even on the Office Christmas Party, I made so many amazing friends on that set, and it was one. I actually quit my nursing job to be on that.
How about that? See, when you reach that point, isn't it a good thing?
No. I'm still a nurse, but I was doing a job I really didn't like at the time, and it was one of those either do Office Christmas Party or, you know, keep a miserable nursing job. And I got rid of the nursing job, and I just it was worth it though. But
by the way, Igor, do we have any stills of Gina's work in The Walking Dead and Office? There we go. There you are. Ooh, look how fabulous!
I look so scared and so pale.
But weren't you supposed to be? Oh look, you're doing it again. I love it.
I figured. I was like, if I lift the hand, I might be seen.
And you go.
There's
behind Jason Bateman, right? Is that who that is?
And Jason Bateman. Olivia Munn. And there's me in the conspicuous red top hat.
Participating in the, what is that called when you do that to someone?
Oh, good question. Shots, I guess. Extreme shots.
The shot love. I love it. So there goes the show. Proven. Yes, she is very professional, very successful. And the point being is that it can be done if you put the time and the work into it.
Yeah.
Also consider aspiring models out there and our own students that maybe you might want to think about taking another path that maybe joining modeling might gear you into acting, designing, owning your own company. You know, that's what I'm finding is that a lot of these kids today don't know how to get into fashion, and they may not necessarily want to be a model, but they figure that that's the best way to do it.
Mm-hmm,
and
then
you find out what might be therein lies your real passion.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just another way of letting you know that there are ways, there are avenues to to get work and to be profitable and to be successful. And Gina is a testament
to
that.
Thank you. I'm still new. I'm still learning and growing. So I really appreciate you saying that.
I always tell them, my students, I say there are several examples of good models working in this area that you should be looking at. Gina Corden is one. Monica Scott Haynes is another one who we know very well. Mm-hmm. Lamont Easter. There are three names right there. These are three models in this area. Follow them. Look them up. See what they're doing.
Oh, yeah. You know, I started off doing fashion in the D.C. area, and I was really close to get representation.
I was trying to scout you.
Yeah. That was back in 2010. But I almost got
sadly, we didn't get her, though.
No. But we got, I was so close to getting representation with a major agency in New York. But, you know, God had different plans for me, and I ended up getting engaged and getting married and moving to South Carolina. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it was really hard because I was also happy at the time because I graduated nursing school, but in my heart, like, I was an artist, and I'm still nursing. I work as a part-time nurse, but I'm also doing that because this is my passion too. And I just feel like, you know, no matter what age you are and no matter what job you have, if you have a passion or a career, if you have a passion for something and you want to make a career out of it, you know, go for it. Don't let anything get in your way. I know that's cliche and everybody knows that, but for a year, I was doing a 9-to-5 miserable nursing job in a nursing office, and I was depressed where I wish I could have, I missed modeling and acting so much. And, you know, little by little, I started taking a little classes here, started getting new headshots, and started arranging my schedule to get what I wanted. And the support that I get from my family and friends is incredible, and my husband. Mm-hmm. And the beautiful thing is I just moved from Columbia, South Carolina to Greenville, which is about a couple hours away from Atlanta, but the good news is I'm so close to Atlanta where I take advantage of the Atlanta opportunities as much as possible. And that's where, you know, they film The Walking Dead, and that's where I film Office Christmas Party. Mm-hmm. But it's one of those, if there's a will, there's a way. If there's a passion in your heart and you want it, go for it. I know it's easier said than done, but you know, a life is going to throw so many obstacles in your way.
That's true.
Don't let that stop you. You know, you got a dream, fight for it, go for it. You're worth it. So that's
I find that the only reason why it sounds cliche or maybe even try it is because it just sounds that way.
Yeah.
But that's what you have to do. You have to put the work in. You have to do what you need to do. You have to go out there. You have to do
that's
the research.
Right.
You have to do the finding as well. And if you're with an agency, then work with your agency. Go in there and talk to your agency. If you find that you've been withering on the vine for a while, then go in there and let that agent know. It's like, look, I have not been working for about 6 months. We need to update my portfolio.
Yeah, you know? I've been there before.
We all have. And if you are working with, if you got an agent worth their salt, they'll be like, honey, come on in. Let's set up a meeting and let's go over your portfolio. Let's see what we need to do to help you because I need to send you to some new clients.
Yes. Yes.
But if you're freelance, then we were talking about this earlier.
Yes.
Surround yourself with some really great supportive people. That helps
absolutely.
As well.
Absolutely. Also, I want to say for any new actors where, you know, this was me 3 years ago where, you know, you didn't know where to start, where to go. And I just joined the Hollywood Winner's Circle. And if you go on Facebook and join the group Talent Management for Actors, it's by Wendy Elaine Wright. And she actually created the Hollywood Winner's Circle where it has everything in different levels. Where if you're a beginner, what you need, what type of headshots, how to format a resume. When I first started, I had so many people tell me different stuff, and I actually had people tell me you can put background work on a resume, and I thought I was so cool, adding that, but then you can't do that. That's frowned upon in the industry. So, but now, within time and doing short films and things like that, I was able to add a little bit more to my resume, it looks a little bit more professional, and, you know, but I thank the Hollywood Winner's Circle for that, but that has been a huge help, and I feel like that course has helped me, and it's not expensive at all, and you have it for life, and I don't understand why more actors don't take advantage of that.
But what's it called again?
Hollywood Winner's Circle.
And can you find this on the internet?
Yeah, you can Google it. Oh, yeah.
Hollywood Winner's Circle. Good. Mm-hmm. All right, y'all hear that out there? I see some of my parents pulling
it's
out.
It's not
fun.
Expensive.
Yeah,
it's
check
worth it.
Out.
It's, yeah.
I'm going to check this out myself. I haven't heard of this, but it sounds like a great reference tool.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And it shows you like how to get a theatrical agent, things like that. But I do feel like the fashion modeling in my past has helped me tremendously to be more expressive as an actor and come out of my shell a little bit more. I'm still shy. I'm still learning. And there's nothing wrong with that, but, you know.
I'm still shy a little bit, too, Gina. Yeah.
Hey, shy kids,
okay,
unite.
Okay, right.
Shy kids in the house.
The introverts were special.
Well, we're going to wrap it up here.
Okay, thank you so much.
But what I would like to thank you. Thank you so much for being one of my first guests on the premiere podcast.
So honored.
The David Perry Show.
David Perry Show.
Remember? Come on, guys.
Oh, yes.
I wanted to tell you that I'd like to bring you back because you have a backstory I definitely would love to talk about and have you discuss that in more details.
Sure.
We won't go into it, but that is something I'd like for some of the viewers to hear.
Absolutely.
Pertaining to some struggles that you had, correct?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I would love for you to talk about that and how you rose.
Yes.
From that madness.
God got me. God got me through that. Okay. And I'm still learning.
Good for you, and you're right here.
Yeah.
Okay, see? Testament to the strength, honey.
Don't give up, people.
Thank you. Thank you, Gina.
Thank you so much.
Oh,
thank
you. Hugs and kisses. Ma and ma. And we're going to take a little break, and we'll be right back, children. David Perry Show. No. Y'all are not working it at all. I'm tired of y'all already. It's like, go home. Y'all got to go.
I think it's the desserts and the champagne.
Is that what it is? Well, that should have made them even more lively. Mm. That's no excuse.
No.
Well, we are back with our third guest of the show. This is Veronica
Iyenga.
And she is the executive director of My Girlfriend's House Incorporated. I'm going to have Veronica tell you a little bit more about that. And I'm going to talk about what she's got upcoming and what I'm going to be helping her with.
Hi, everyone. Being involved with. I know. I'm Veronica Iyenga.
Yay!
I am the executive director and founder of a Maryland-based nonprofit called My Girlfriend's House. It is a leadership mentoring program for teenage girls in the D.C., Maryland region.
Mm-hmm.
During the summer months, what we actually do is we run a fashion boot camp. And David, okay, brought all the dramatics last year. I mean, the twirls, the flips, everything.
Yes, and they did a fashion show. The fashion show culminated in your summer boot camp.
Uh-huh.
I think the one that was for fashion, right? Because you have two, fashion. And
yeah, we have three. Yeah.
Fabulous. And the one for fashion, the girls, they designed outfits out of recyclable materials, and they presented their show. This flyer that you're seeing right now is for the upcoming fashion show that's coming up that I will be helping with again. Veronica brought me on to host a fashion show, and it was at Iverson Mall. I had a fabulous time. So I'm going to come back again Friday, July 5th. You see the date and time, 6 to 9. You're invited. Tell me more about this. Is it going to be different this year?
Yeah, I mean, actually, we brought you on last year to just kind of give the girls a little bit of black girl magic.
And I did.
And you came and you showed them how to find their inner selves and just have fun being in their skin and modeling. The cool thing about this is we're doing environmental green thinking with the girls. So we spent 2 weeks learning everything about why the environment is necessary for saving and recycling. And then the girls would design 5 or 6 different outfits made out of complete recyclable stuff.
Fabulous stuff. They have some fabulous creation. Yeah.
So you have like the newspaper look, which I think is the one you just showed us on the screen. They have a trash bag look, which is like an all-white formal look that they really pull together. They have a cereal box look, so that's our fun, colorful one. And then, of course, their fringe look. And then this year, we're adding like the plastic spoon look.
Wow, I can't wait to see
really,
that one.
Right, to really kind of work on the embellishments of the fringe effect. So what's cool is, you know, the girls meet with so many different people in the industry. They find their genius. They learn to sew. And then you are the icing on the cake to give them that self-confidence.
Veronica.
Because they need that. Otherwise, it feels real stiff and it's not natural. And we want them to twirl and to flip and to do whatever they want to do that they feel is, you know, like natural for them.
That was the point of... me wanting to help them the way I wanted to help them, because in this case, I know a lot of times certain fashion shows, they want you to be sort of stiff or move a certain way. In this case, I wanted those girls to turn it, have fun, swirl, twirl, pose, get their life, because that was the point of it. They were supposed to have fun, and I wanted them to feel comfortable about showing off their outfits. They put a lot of work into making those fabulous. I saw empire waistlines, and I saw a jacket and skirt set. I mean, these girls were fabulous.
No, they did an amazing job. And then, of course, you know, the end is the fashion show at the mall.
Yes.
So this year, we're hosting it again at Iverson Mall.
And I'll be there.
You'll
and
be there
I hope you all be there. And we remember we brought some the guests on stage. We brought some of the had the women come, and then we had the men. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to work with the men a little bit more next time. And it was all fun. Maybe I'll bring them up first this time. But it was just a great time. And I want to thank you for bringing me on. And I rehearsed with them and coached them. It was just great.
Yeah, I mean, I really appreciate you. I love your energy. I mean, I think that was the whole thing for us. We just wanted it to be ridiculously fun for the girls.
And it was.
Because the sewing process is a lot of work. But while they enjoy it, it feels like a lot of work. But when they did their modeling workshops or their dancing workshops or their poetry workshops, it brought it all in together. And you were a big part of that. So thank you.
Well, I mean, they put a lot of work and time into it. So, of course, they should... have fun showing off all of their creations and their hard work.
Absolutely.
And as I said before, I think I'm the one that probably had a little bit more fun than they did. as usual, you know what I mean? Because it really was. It was a great time. Is there anything else upcoming? I know the two camps that you have.
We have the fashion camp. That's going to run from June 24th to July the 5th. July 5th, the day after the 4th of July. Then the following Monday, we go into our STEM camp, and
we take on
cosmetic chemistry. So for 2 weeks, they're going to learn everything about the makeup industry and end up designing their own organic makeup line.
How about that? Isn't that fabulous? You know what? You need to come back on another time, too, and for a longer time. Yeah. And then that way, what we can do is bring in some of the girls and maybe have them present what they've done, especially this fragrance that you're talking about that they're working on. Did you know that they have a CoverGirl plant here in Baltimore? Are you planning on taking them?
Our interns have been on it, trying to get that
appointment. That's what I'm talking about. Did y'all know that there's a CoverGirl plant operation located here in Baltimore, Maryland? Check it out. Got CoverGirl in our backyard, honey. My goodness.
And then the last camp is the leadership one.
Tell us about that
one, please. For leadership, we take on... we take on the advocacy for missing teenagers and how they don't get an Amber Alert.
Right.
So for 2 weeks, our girls are going to learn everything there is to know about the missing child syndrome, including visiting police in the jurisdiction, touring the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, as well as meeting with families of children that have actually gone missing. Their end result is that on August the 4th, I believe, that's the 3rd, that's Saturday in August, they're going to end up hosting their Missing Children Awareness event.
Oh, wow. Make sure you keep me updated and posted on that, okay?
Yes, absolutely. I will.
Because I was just about to ask you, is there anything on the horizons like some type of fundraisers or event galas to be promoting the Camp Divalicious or what the organization or My Girlfriend's House Incorporated?
Yeah, I mean, you can always, you know, we're an all-volunteer organization. So as a nonprofit working with teenagers, we always have a financial need. So if you feel it, you know, where you're able to donate, definitely visit our website at www.mygirlfriendshouse.org. And whether you want to support the summer camps or you want to support the year-long mentoring program, there's always an opportunity to get involved.
Good. All right. You got that? And do you have, and what's your website?
www.mygirlfriendshouse.org. And that's girlfriends with an S.
You got that, people? Just check in with us on Facebook and we'll make sure you get that information. Okay. If you forgot to write down the website name. Veronica, I would love to keep you up here longer, but we got to wrap it up now. And I really appreciate you coming in and being one of my first guests on the premiere podcast of
The David Perry Show.
Y'all have got to go get a copy of Hairspray, the Divine Version. Check it out. You see exactly what I'm talking about. Thank you, Veronica.
Thank you, David. Enjoy yourself.
I certainly will. All right. We're going to take one more quick break. I'm going to come back. I'm going to wrap it up. And then we're going to say goodbye. And we'll be right back. Welcome back one more time to the premiere podcast of the David Perry Show. All right, okay, I've been working on this all night long. We got it, good. Okay, guys, as I said before, we're just going to do a really quick wrap-up, and I just want to let you know that I'm going to be coming back next month, June 16th, I think it is. I'll double-check on the date. I'm going to be here for, I'm committed to be doing my show here at Listen Vision Studios once a month, so I'm going to be committed up until December, so you'll be seeing my lovely face and my big mouth up here in these studios or working it behind this microphone for once a month up until December, so please do tune in. I want to say thank you to everybody who tuned in on Facebook Live, who tuned in out there in the internet world. I really appreciate this. I can't wait to get started with more. And at some point, I think I'm going to be strong enough, I guess you could say, to try to go weekly. But we'll talk about that. But while I have all my guests up here, is there anything that you guys want to say before you have to go off? Iffy, anything you want to say? Or Veronica, anything you want to say? Quickly.
I'm super proud of you. Yes.
Thank you.
Think about moving forward, but they don't have the guts to take the step. And here you are. Look at you.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you.
Look at you.
Thank you.
Well said.
Yes.
Yeah, well said.
Nerve, I don't lack in.
It's okay.
And you look fabulous, by the way. You look fabulous. Amazing.
Thank you, God.
Face so big.
Those lashes.
Thank you to Karen Bonita. She turned me out, honey. I look like I got perfect skin, don't I? And this outfit, actually, speaking of Crystal Couture, Gina, I got this from one of the designers that was showing at Crystal Couture. Yeah. Many years back, so that's where this comes from.
Okay.
The hat, it's from the Cleopatra Couture line. Thank you very much. Paige and Chandler are from their parents. And Veronica is from her mother. Yes, can you tell we're winding it down a little bit here, guys? But basically, the bottom line is I really enjoyed this. My first show, I feel comfortable about what we're doing. I definitely can do this again. As I said before, all my guests that came on, Veronica, Ife, and Gina, you guys have got to come back for a little longer time because you got a lot to talk about.
Absolutely.
So we're going to be doing that. And I'm going to be working on bringing in a lot of great guests, some local talent here in this area that needs to be featured. So I got my work cut out for me, and I'm ready. So, anybody got anything to say? We still got a few more minutes here.
I just want to say something.
Certainly, Gina.
David, thank you so much for inviting all of us here, and I'm so proud of you. And I remember when we talked on the phone, I thought to myself, he's got a great radio voice. You know, he needs to be doing this, and you have the personality for this, and we're all of us are so proud of you. And you keep doing exactly what you're doing. I'm proud of you.
I certainly will. You guys are wonderful for my soul. Don't you love how she said great radio voice? What, you have nothing to say about my face?
Oh, you Your face is gorgeous. It is.
You know what they mean when they say you got a great radio voice.
No. You're a gorgeous face and a great radio voice. You got it all together.
I got it all. Well, my mother thanks you too. And these two cheekbones, my body hangs off these two cheekbones. But
I just want to say something. I'm sure. So happy that you started your podcast being real to yourself, being who you are. This is David Perry that we know. You didn't have to change it. You didn't have to sugarcoat it. Love it or hate it, we love it. So congratulations.
Absolutely.
Aren't these guys the greatest? I mean, isn't this the best premiere podcast show ever? Oh, my God. I think I'll be able to walk
drinking?
Out.
Let's go drinking then.
Yes, we're going to go. Yes, I'm going to let them go. We're going to take another break. I'm just going to say goodbye, and then we're going to remove ourselves for the next show. So we're going to take a little break, and we'll be right back. Thank you, guys, again. Hi, everybody. I only got about a minute to just wrap it up and say goodnight. I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who tuned in to my very first show. And I also want to remind you that in my future shows, I am going to be wearing some fabulous outfits, even more fabulous than the one I'm wearing tonight. So tune in. If you only just want to come in and tune in just to see my fabulous fashions, you can do that. But please come and see the show. It's going to be a fabulous show. And once again, I'm going to be wearing some great outfits. So tune in next month. 8 to 9. Look for the details of the date. I'll make sure you get them. And once again, thank you everybody to the for the David Perry Show.